Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all are staying fit and healthy. Myself, Ms. Surbhi Sharma from Shivjyoti Educational Group. So, as you all know, we have already completed with our course. Now, today we are going to proceed with the revision of Chapter 3 and Chapter 4 of Civics. Please keep pencils in your hand, your rough copy, and your book should be open. Okay? So, this is your book, okay? I hope you all must have purchased the book. Chapter 3, How the State Government Works. Okay, so today we are going to start with the chapter 3. As you all know, we have already done with this chapter. What you have done in this chapter? Okay, so this chapter is basically about state government, how the state government works. So let's start with the points to remember. First point, levels of government. So if we talk about different levels of government, I have just now told you there are three levels of the government. Now what are those three levels? Okay, if we talk about levels of government, there are basically three levels. First one is the government which works at central level, then next it works at state level, and third it works at local level or district level. Okay, so generally if we talk about government, it works at three levels, that is central, state and local. Okay, now basically in this chapter we are going to read about the state government. Okay, now moving towards the second point, that is state government. Now see, I have already told you there are three levels of the government: central, state and local. Now what is state government? How state government is formed? Okay, so if we talk about state government, see, different MLAs are there which are being chosen by us only. Okay, we choose our own representatives from where? From our own constituency. Now you all must be wondering, what is constituency, who is an MLA? So we were talking about the state government, how state government is formed. Okay, just now I have told you this is the second level of the government. So state government. Okay, so see how state government is formed. Okay, now see, legislative assembly is there. Okay, legislative assembly. Okay, where all the meetings related to the state or related to any issue in that particular state is held. Okay, now who all sits in the legislative assembly? Okay, MLAs, then ministers and chief minister. Okay, so MLAs, ministers and chief minister sits in the legislative assembly. Okay, I hope till here it is very clear. State government, okay, legislative assembly is there where all the meetings are held. Okay, that in that meeting all the MLAs, ministers and chief ministers sit together. Now the question arises, how MLAs are being appointed? Okay, how MLAs are being appointed? So let me tell you, see, a constituency is there. Okay, this is your state. Okay, for just suppose this is state. Okay, in this particular state different constituencies will be there. Okay, different constituencies will be there. So according to you, how many constituencies are there? Constituencies is the number of areas in which state is divided. Okay, now you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So total 7 constituency is there in this state. Okay, you just have to assume. Okay, now from each constituency, total 7 constituencies are there. From each constituency, just suppose 2 parties are there, BJP and Congress. Okay, here also BJP and Congress, here also BJP, Congress. Same in all the constituencies. Okay, BJP and Congress. Okay, so 2 parties are there. Now from each constituency, 1 MLA from BJP, okay, 1 representative you can say, and 1 from Congress will stand in the election. Okay, now it's our choice to whom we elect. Either we vote for BJP or we vote for Congress. This is for all the constituencies, 1 from BJP, 1 from Congress. Same goes for all the constituencies. Okay, till now it is clear. Now comes how the ruling party and opposition party is formed. Like for example, if we talk about constituencies, see, from 1st, 2nd, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 constituencies are there. From 1st constituency, BJP, MLA from BJP got elected. Okay. From 2nd, from Congress, 3rd again, BJP, 4th again, BJP, 5th again, BJP, and 6th again, BJP, and 7th goes for Congress. Okay. So, till now it is very clear. Okay. So, from 1st constituency, BJP government will be there. Okay. From each constituency, MLA stands. Okay. Now, from all 7 constituencies, total 7 seats were there. Okay. Total seats was 7. Okay. Won by BJP was, you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, out of 7, 5 seats were won by BJP. And if we talk about Congress, then how many? 1 and 2. Only 2 seats were won by Congress. So see, maximum votes were BJP were having. Okay, maximum votes were BJP were having. Maximum seats were won by the BJP. So BJP will be the ruling party. Okay, and Congress will be the opposition party. Okay, so is it clear? Ruling party and opposition party. So this is how MLAs are being appointed. Okay, so BJP 5 MLAs and Congress 2 MLAs. Okay, now whenever the meeting is held, all the MLAs, no matter whether from the ruling party or from the opposition party, the both the parties MLAs will sit together in the legislative assembly. Okay, but if we talk about ruling and opposition party, who is the ruling party? BJP is the ruling party, and the head of the state, that is chief minister, chief minister will also be from the ruling party. Sorry, chief minister. Okay, that will be from the ruling party. So is it clear how state government is formed? I have told you, state is there, different constituencies. You can see, I have told you, 7 constituencies were there. From each constituency, BJP and Congress, one person, one representative sent for the election. Okay, so after the elections, after we cast our votes, from each constituency, one MLA has been elected. Okay, from first BJP, from second Congress, third BJP, fourth BJP, fifth BJP, sixth BJP, and seventh again Congress. Okay, so the maximum seats were won by BJP. BJP became the ruling party and Congress became the opposition party. Is it clear? Okay. Now, no matter to which party MLAs belong, ruling or opposition, they all will sit together in the legislative assembly whenever the meeting held or any issues or any discussions has to be there. Okay, by the chief minister. Okay. Now, moving towards the third point, that is MLAs. MLA members of legislative assembly. Just now I have explained you the full chart. Okay, ruling party and opposition party. Who are the ruling party and opposition party? Tell me. Just now I have explained you on the board. Ruling party, the party which won the maximum votes from maximum constituency, the party who won. Like I have just now told you, BJP won from the maximum constituencies. So BJP will be the ruling party, okay, and the other parties will be the opposition party. Next comes constituency. Again, constituency, just now I have explained, state is divided into different parts, that is constituency, and from each constituency one representative sends for the elections from different parties. Then working of the government. Okay, now this we will be reading in different answers. Okay, but this is all about how the state government works. Okay, working of the government, I have told you different MLAs, ministers, chief ministers sit together in the legislative assembly. I have told you legislative assembly. Okay, the Rajasthan's legislative assembly is there in Jaipur. Okay, so if any discussions has to be there or any decision they have to take, so they all will sit together in the legislative assembly and takes their decision. And how they have to work for their state, how they have to work in their own constituencies, every in each kind of discussions takes place in the legislative assembly, and that is how government works. So now moving towards the internal questions. Now you all open up your books, everyone, open up your books please. Okay, so your first question is define constituency. For this you have to come on page number 41. Open page number 41. You can find this definition in the glossary, it's there. Okay, write down the question there, define constituency, page number 41, and answer you will find in the glossary itself. A particular area from which all the voters living there choose their representatives. Okay, question number 2, how is the governor of a state is appointed? For this question you have to come on page number 33. Open page number 33, everyone. Okay, it's there in cursive letters. Okay, you can find this answer here in cursive letters. Okay, full answer you have to mark. Okay, the head of the state is the governor. He is appointed by the central government to ensure that the state government works within the rules and regulations of the constitution. Mark this answer and write down the question very carefully. Now if the question comes, how is the governor of the state appointed? Yeah, who appoints the governor of the state? Who appoints? Central government appoints the governor of the state. Question number 3, what is a wallpaper project? For this come on page number 39. Open page number 39, everyone. It's there. Okay, you will find the answer here, wallpaper project. Write down the question and your answer is, a wallpaper is an interesting activity through which research can be done on particular topics of interest. Okay, like some topics has been given and on that the students have to research different things. So this is all about your internal questions. Please mark the internal questions very carefully, okay, and also learn it. Now moving towards the copy work, I hope you all must have done with the copy work. I'm just going to explain you the question and answers. Chapter 3, how the state government works. Short answer type questions. First question is, what are the 3 levels of the government in India? See, don't panic, this chapter has been provided to you in 2 parts. Okay, so all the questions will must be there with you in the PDF. So but the numbering might be some upside and down. Okay, but don't panic, you will find the questions. क्वेश्चन वन, व्हाट आर द थ्री लेवल्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इन इंडिया, टेल मी. आई हैव जस्ट नाउ एक्सप्लेन्ड यू गवर्नमेंट वर्क्स एट थ्री लेवल्स, दैट इज सेंट्रल, दैट इज नेशनल, नेशनल सेंट्रल वन एंड द सेम थिंग, नेशनल, स्टेट एंड लोकल लेवल. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, व्हाट इज अ लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली. यस, व्हाट इज अ लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली, जस्ट नाउ आई हैव टोल्ड यू वेयर ऑल द MLAs, मिनिस्टर्स, चीफ मिनिस्टर्स, एवरीवन सिट्स टुगेदर एंड डू द डिस्कशन रिगार्डिंग वेरियस इश्यूज. अ लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली इज अ प्लेस वेयर ऑल द MLAs, वेदर फ्रॉम रूलिंग पार्टी और अपोजिशन, नीड टू डिस्कस वेरियस इश्यूज रिगार्डिंग द स्टेट्स और रिगार्डिंग देयर कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज. क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री, हाउ डू सम MLAs बिकम मिनिस्टर्स, एक्सप्लेन. द MLAs बिलोंगिंग टू द रूलिंग पार्टी विल इलेक्ट देयर लीडर हु विल बिकम द चीफ मिनिस्टर. सो आई हैव टोल्ड यू द रूलिंग पार्टी एंड अपोजिशन पार्टी, सो चीफ मिनिस्टर विल बी फ्रॉम द रूलिंग पार्टी इटसेल्फ एंड द MLAs फ्रॉम द रूलिंग पार्टी विल बी चूजिंग देयर हेड हु विल बिकम द चीफ मिनिस्टर. Chief Minister then selects other people as ministers and the governor appoints them. Okay, governor, who appoints the governor? Central government. And see, Chief Minister selects other people as minister. Now let me tell you, see, these ministers are the MLAs only. Okay, MLAs are having two dual responsibilities, one as an MLA and other one as a minister. Might be they can be agriculture minister, sports minister, infrastructure minister. Okay, so they holds dual responsibilities. What is the difference between the work that MLA do in the assembly and the work done by government departments? Differences between the work that MLA do in the assembly and the work done by government departments are, an MLA works for well-being of people, he raises issues in the legislative assembly. Okay, if he is having any problem or the people in his constituency is facing any problem, he will raise those issues in the legislative assembly and demand solution to the problems. To whom he demands? Either to the minister of that particular area, like if he is facing problem in the sanitation, so the minister who is having the responsibility of sanitation facilities, he will be discussing and asking for the solution from that minister and the chief minister also. The government departments implements decisions taken in the legislative assembly. So whatever decisions are being taken by the MLAs, different ministers or chief ministers, all the ministers are being implemented in the legislative assembly, in their particular constituencies. Now question number 5, long answer type question. Why should decisions taken by the chief minister and other ministers be debated in the legislative assembly? Decisions should be debated as the decisions taken by the government have to be approved by the member of the legislative assembly. Now whatever decisions are taken by the government, okay, chief minister, first he also has to discuss those decisions with the MLAs, okay, because that particular constituency belongs to the MLA. So if chief minister wants any change, first he has to discuss with the MLA and there should be a approval from the MLAs to make that change. In a democracy, these members can ask questions, debate on important issues, decide where money should be spent, etc. They have the main authority. Why they have the main authority? Because they are the ones who are regulating their constituency. They are the head of their constituency. Third, the minister of the concerned department replies to the questions and informs the assemblies about the steps taken. Okay, the minister of the concerned department, that means like for example agriculture department. So the minister of agriculture department will takes decisions and will tell to each and every MLA of different constituency. Okay, so the minister of the concerned department replies to the questions and inform the assemblies about the steps taken. So children, but now we are moving upon question number 6, that is, use the terms constituency and represent to explain who is an MLA and how is the person elected. Now if the question is there, who is an MLA, so this should be very clear to you that who is an MLA. I have just now told you member of legislative assembly, and who choose member of legislative assembly? We people. Okay, and how is the person elected? That is also I have told you. MLA is a member of the legislative assembly who is elected by the people, and hence this way they represent people. A person is elected, how a person is elected? Okay, MLA, how MLA represent people? Because he is chosen by us, we people choose MLA, so that's why he represent people. Now a person is elected. Each state is divided into different areas or constituencies. Abhi samjhaya tha aapko board pe maine. Elections are organized in each constituency. Okay, two persons or different persons stands from different parties. People from each constituency vote for their representatives. The person attaining maximum vote is then elected as an MLA. Okay, so the whomsoever will get the maximum votes will be declared as MLA. So children, this was all about our chapter 3. I hope you all understood all the points, each and everything, very carefully. If you are having any doubt regarding any topic, you can ask in the doubt session. And please go through this video, points to remember, and the chapter also. Now we will be continuing with the chapter 4.